We've got the main up, albeit not right exactly. But it's a start. Hit the jib on. Alright, so it's the first time this boat's been out on the sea for a while, I think. It's been in storage here and there, and now she's having her first trip. As you can hear, we've got a few knots going on. She's not a fast boat anyway, I don't think, because she's quite wide, but she's doing alright. I mean, I haven't got that much set up either. Now we're coming back into the river. Yes, my jib's still loose at the bottom. I'm going to hank it lower down. I've quite got enough length in the wire. Not worrying. Well, it's the end of my first day's proper sail testing in the state. So, I've been out on the sea, been under a jib and main, in sort of 2 to 4 strength conditions, and it's been a nice day. I was sailing back into the river, I went out offshore for a bit, a couple of hours. I was coming back in the river with the tide and my engine wouldn't start. Smelt fuely. Wouldn't start. And I did bring this plug span or anything, so I couldn't do anything really. But I sailed up through the moorings, tacking with the jib on still. That was alright actually. I was a bit cautious and a bit concerned because I haven't done that yet in this boat. It's a bit less manoeuvrable than my little ones. I got back to Port Narvos, no stress, no incident, and anchored up, and then after a few minutes messing around, the engine started. I was starting to think, am I going to be able to get back to my mooring? Top of the tide, yeah, quick. But engine seems to be okay now, so I don't know. It's obviously a bit flooded, but I didn't really flood it. I don't know. We'll have to keep an eye on that. It's a little bit underpowered as well. It's all right. It's got me where I need to go. It does swing around and give me a reverse sort of thing. Or turn around. But if I have a bigger engine, then it's hard to get in and out of the well, and I don't like leaving an engine in the water all the time. So I don't know, the conundrum continues. Maybe electric is a thing. We'll see. Lovely day though. Had a great sail, had a great day. Just a great day, just made a cup of tea. So I'm going to drink that, get some food on, and relax for the rest of the day. So, part of boating is cooking. So, time to get some dinner on. Just going for the spud. Tranger spud. You know, I think I even booked some salt, but I don't know where it is. Maybe I'll find that off camera. There we go. Chippy choppy choppy. There's a bit of something there. Let's chop that off. Super efficient anyway, but yeah, there's a bit of something there, we'll chop that off. Throw that out to the fishes. Big fishes. Right, when you've got the water board, then we'll pull that in there. I'll have to salt it in a minute. And then might need 2 hands for this. Yeah, I will. So I'm going to put the little spuds on there. I suppose we can juggle it. So just like that. Grab the old transit thingy. Get that on there. I might make a gimbaled cookery transit arrangement. Some DCA chaps have done some good little kitchen boxes. I might do the same. So we're just gonna spud boil that for a bit. I didn't bring your steamer. A steamer is a good little thing to have on a boat, you know. Saves a bit of cooking time and water, because you only need a little tiny bit. There you go. So we're gonna wait for them to boil, and then I'll get something else on to go with it. Hey, now we've got the halloumi cooking, and I think I got some beetroot and vinegar in my bag, so that'll be a meal, won't it? Here we are, it's a bit hard to see with the light, but here's me spud halloumi and beetroot. I'm not going to do what they do in these videos and get you to watch me eating it. I'm just going to eat it. You have a good evening. Eat your food and I'll eat.